Hi, this is Doug Joseph with Design 8 Studio with some tips and tricks about registration and grid and squareness on the Lowrider mostly printed CNC. I'm using Lowrider version 3. Whenever you try to do a CNC cut job that requires cuts on both the top and the bottom, then when you go to flip that piece, you need to be able to have it put in just the right spot so that the cuts on the top are coordinated with the cuts on the bottom properly. And this means that you need to have some type of a grid or some type of a rail in place that you're butting that piece up against, or lines that you're putting it up against. And another thing to be aware of is that even if your side rails are perfectly parallel, your end stops may not be located exactly square to each other. On the V1 Engineering website, under the Lowrider section, there are steps describing how to check for squareness. And those steps involve putting paper or tape at the corners and then using a pen to mark a point on the four corners and then measuring the diagonals across those corners to see if everything matches up. The larger you can draw this rectangle or square, the more accurate your measurement and testing will be. Once you get the amount by which you are out, assuming there is a little bit, then that can be compensated not so much by moving your end stops, but by inserting a G-code command that stores the amount of offset inside the firmware of your main board. And once you do this, you'll notice that when you home your device on the X and Y axes, then that offset will kick in after homing, and you'll see it. For instance, if this side is skewed away, once it homes, you'll see it home, and then it'll bring this side back out to compensate for that skew. I'm going to be checking mine. I had checked it earlier. I had entered the commands, but somehow over time, my firmware seems to have lost those commands. Maybe I did a firmware upgrade without remembering that I would be losing something. And so I need to measure again and input those commands again. But once I do it this time, I'm going to use that pen to mark a grid. I'm thinking probably one grid line every inch or so, because I've got some projects that I need to flip the part in the middle of the project, and I need proper registration so the top cuts match the bottom cuts. Let's get started. Oh, hey, one last thought before we get started. I wish that I had drawn this grid when I had freshly resurfaced my spoil board. I've got basically artifacts on my spoil board, gouges from jobs that are done, and I wish I had marked that grid before then. Now my pen is gonna have to be dragging and skipping across those gouges. So just bear in mind, when you first get your Lowrider set up, go ahead and draw that grid. So to create our lines, I'll be using a vector illustration program. I'm gonna use it both to create those corner marks for checking squareness and also the lines for drawing my grid. Now I'm using an old copy of CorelDRAW running inside a virtual machine, a Windows virtual machine on my Mac. There are free vector illustration programs. Inkscape comes to mind. So if you don't have access to Adobe Illustrator or CorelDRAW, then you can use free vector illustration programs to get this done. Okay, I'm just gonna do a high-speed fly through the work in ESOCAM to prepare the G-code. It's kind of beyond the scope of this video to do a slow, in-depth tutorial on ESOCAM, although I may do that coming up sometime in the future. So just know that I used ESOCAM, prepared the G-code file, and now it's time to head over to the Lowrider 3 to actually do some marking and calibration tests. Okay, so here you see me using a tape measure to measure my diagonals after I've already marked my four corners. So here are the commands that I enter in order to get my system calibrated, and I still have yet to test to make sure that this amount of offset is the right amount. But I enter M666 X negative 10. I hit send, tap anywhere, and then I lock it in to EEPROM by M500. And then when I home, my X and Y, I get this nice offset right here, which is what I needed. And on this side, I don't get any offset. Now, most of you would enter Y, because for most of you, this rail is on your Y axis. I have mine switched. My X and Y axis are switched. So for me, this is my Y axis and this is my X. So if I needed this side to move over, then I would have entered a positive number. But because I needed this side to move over, I entered a negative number. So now I will redo my testing and see if this amount of offset is the correct amount. Okay, so I've homed and I've got my pin ready to mark, and now I'm going to rerun the file that marks . Okay, so I'm about to start drawing a grid on my spool board after having recalibrated, checking for squareness, setting my offset with the M666 G-code command. Okay, so the project is done now, and it took a whopping 2 hours and 20 minutes, and I had two of these Ryobi markers that both were giving out on me. Apparently it's a challenge to do this, and I kept swapping them out, but I did want to go ahead and show you that I was able to get a grid, and it's going to be very helpful to me. And I do want to reiterate, in closing thoughts, I really wish I had done it as soon as I first surfaced the spool board, as it was a bit of a challenge to get the pin over the humps and ruts. And but I'm very glad to have gotten this done. It's going to help me, and I'll be using this to get some wood registered on the next project I'm going to be working on. And so until the next time, this is Doug Joseph with Design 8 Studio, wishing you happy making.